Every night when I was young, we'd light a candle by my bed and look at all the stars he painted high above my head. He said everyone a symbol of a lesson he would teach. Then he painted some all down my wall so I'd have them right in reach. It wasn't long before they all came down. Stepmother said that they were gauche and she erased them. And though I haven't wished upon my father's stars in years, I can't count how many thousand times I've traced them. And it makes me want to cry, though I'm anything but sad. For you answered me a prayer today I didn't know I had. I searched everywhere I could. I looked everywhere I knew, and for so long he was nowhere to be found. But here all I have to do is look around, and I remember. I did just what I was told, and I didn't say a thing. I thought living
a glass and wipe your eye for my bygone days at Springbrook High, and the class I learned to dread, the ego buster they called Phys Ed. Basketball, baseball, football, stickball, volleyball, softball, tetherball, kickball, playing was hell, but worst of all was the ritual that came first of all. All right, captains, pick your teams. Last one picked, non-athletic. Last one picked, at sports I was pathetic. other kids could tumble and run, but my coordination was totally on. Six guys left, stomach sinking. Three guys left, my self-esteem was shrinking. Felt so ashamed, I could have cried. Nobody wanted me on their side. How many notes did I forge to say? Please excuse Patrick from gym today. He wrenched his back, his colon's spastic. He's got laryngitis and his kneecaps are plastic. I was the last one picked, rejected by the rabble. Last one picked, I could beat them all at Scrabble. My brains didn't do me a bit of good. The bottom of the barrel was where I stood. And time went by and I met you and learned that a team could consist of two. The man I was A-OK, and who cared about kids' games anyway? Last one picked, the past is past now. Last one picked, at last I'm not the last now. I'm first class pick on a winning team, like I always dreamed I'd be. Imagine my surprise when out of all those other guys, oh, you picked me. Go team.
Took my hand and showed me how. You promised me you'd be around. That's right. I took your words and I believed in everything you said to me. That's right. If someone said 3 years from now you'd be long gone, I'd stand up and punch them out, 'cause they're all wrong. They knew better. Still you said forever and ever. No. my prize. But you must realize, my boys, other girls' luxuries are my necessities. Somebody beware.
With the
need to love me or tell me that you do. Don't make me any promises, just promise we're not through. Don't give me one damn thing, I won't let you call this greed. Just let me give to you, that's the only thing I need. I know that this can work, if you plant one simple seed, you'd see it grow. Don't need to love me to know. You don't need to need me. It's better if you don't. If each of us can walk away, matter that I won't. We'll both be self-contained, but together, not alone. You can keep me in the dark, hell, it's all I've ever known. But we both could use a friend who will always check the phone and take the call. You don't need to need me at all. Let me be your emergency contact, occasional plus one, your excuse to take a sick day when the forecast calls for sun. We can keep on being lonely, but we don't have to be apart. And I'll never even ask you to let me have your heart, so I'll never break your heart. No, I'll never your heart. You don't need to love me to let me help you through. You don't need to confide in me. I've got crap enough for two. You don't need to answer. I'll know before you do. But hear me and believe me that you don't need to love me.
Never cease. Didn't like her. Didn't like her. I couldn't stand her. Couldn't stand her. Wouldn't have her. I never knew her. But now I do. And I could. And I would. And I know. She loves me. And to my amazement, I love it, knowing that she loves me. She loves me, true she doesn't show it. How could she, when she doesn't know it? Yesterday she loathed me, now today she likes me. And tomorrow, tomorrow, oh. To touch her. I'm speechless, for I mustn't tell her. It's wrong now, but it won't be long now before my love discovers that she and I are lovers. Imagine how surprised she's bound to be. She loves me. She loves me. I love her, isn't that a wonder? I wonder why I didn't want her. I want her, that's the thing that matters. And matters, are improving daily. Yesterday I loathed her. Ah, now today I love her. Ah, and tomorrow, tomorrow. Oh, I'm tingling, such delicious tingles. I'm trembling, what the hell does that mean? And I'm freezing, that's because it's cold out. And still I'm incandescent, and like some adolescent, I'd like to scrawl on every wall I see. She loves me. Loves me.
There's a man who's been out sailing in a decade full of dreams, and he takes her to a schooner, and he treats her like a queen. Bearing beads from California with their amber stones and green. He has called her from the harbor. He has kissed her with his freedom. He has heard her off to starboard in the breaking and the breathing of the water weeds. While she busy being free. There's a man who's climbed a mountain and he's calling out her name. And he hopes her heart can hear. 3,000 miles he calls again. He can think her there beside him. He can miss her just the same. He has missed her in the forest. While he showed her all the flowers, and the branches sang the chorus as he climbed the scaly towers of a forest tree. While she was somewhere being free. There's a man who sent a letter. And he's waiting for reply. He has asked her of her travels since the day they said goodbye. He writes, "Wish you were beside me. We can make it if we try." He has seen her at the office with her name on all his papers. Through the sharing of the profits, he will find it hard to shake her from his memory. And she's so busy being free. There's a lady in the city, and she thinks she loves them all. There's the one who's thinking of her. There's the one who sometimes calls. There's the one who writes her letters with his facts and figure scrawl. She has brought them to her senses. They have laughed inside her laughter. Now she rallies her defenses, for she fears that one will ask her for eternity. Sends her medals. He is bleeding from the war. There's a jouster and a jester and a man who owns a store. There's a drummer and a dreamer, and you know, there may be more. She will love them when she sees them. They will lose her if they follow, and she only means to please them. And her heart is full and hollow, like a cactus tree. And she's so busy. free. Like a cactus tree, being free.
Make a toast. Here's to the ladies who lunch. Everybody laugh. Loud. lounging in their caftans and planning a brunch on their own behalf. Off to the gym, then to a fitting, claiming their fat, while looking grim, 'cause they've been sitting, choosing a hat. Does anybody still wear a hat? I'll drink to that. Here's for the girls who stay smart. Aren't they a gas? Rushing to their classes in optical art, wishing it would pass. Another long, exhausting day. Another $1,000. A matinee, a Pinter play. Perhaps a piece of Mahler's. I'll drink to that. And one for Mahler. And here's to the girls who play wife. Aren't they too much? Keeping house but clutching a copy of life just to stay in touch.
Attentions of the male sex? Just check out my new book, 100 Easy Ways to Lose a Man. Chapter 1. Now the first way to lose a man. You've met a charming fellow and you're out for a spin. The motor fails and he just wears a helpless grin. Don't bat your eyes and say, what a romantic spot we're in. Just get out, crawl under the car, say it's the gasket, and fix it in 2 seconds flat with a bobby pin. That's a swell way to lose a man. He takes you to a baseball game, you sit knee to knee. He says, the next guy up at bat'll bunt. You'll see. Don't say, what's the fun? This game's too hard for little old me. Just say, bunt, what are you, nuts? With no outs, two men on base, and a left-handed batter coming up, they'll walk right to a triple play just like it happened in the fifth game of the World Series in 1923. That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure, 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 sure way to lose a man. A dandy way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. He'll never try for second base. 98 ways to go. Now the third way to lose a man. The lifeguard at the beach that all the girlies adore swims bravely out to save you through the ocean's roar. Don't say, oh, thanks. I would have drowned in just 1 second more. Just push his head under the water, your last one in's a rotten egg, and race him back to shore. That's a fine way to lose a man. You've met your perfect mate, and it's been love from the start. He says, you're the one to who I give my heart. Don't say, I love you too, my dear. Let's never, never part. Just say, I'm afraid you've made a grammatical error. It is not to who I give my heart, it is to whom I give my heart. You see, with the use of the preposition to, whom becomes the indirect object, making the use of whom imperative, which I can easily show you by drawing a simple chart. That's a fine way to lose a man. A fine, 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 fine way to lose a man. A dandy way to lose a man. Just be more well-informed than he. You'll never hear, oh, promise me. Just show him where his grammar errs, then mark your towels, hers and hers. Yes, girls, you too can lose your man if you would use my easy plan. 100 easy ways to lose a man.
Seems to breathe a sigh. Sometimes I hear a neighbor snoring. Sometimes I hear a baby cry. Sometimes I hear a staircase creaking. Sometimes a distant telephone. Then the quiet settles down again. The house and I are all alone. Romantic. down. I'm lonely in this lonely house. In this lonely
what happened last night? Are you really here? Joan, 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 Joan. Hi, Joan, don't wake up, Joan. Oh my God, last night. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, last night. I got so excited, I was too enthusiastic. Thank you for not laughing while you laughed a little bit. At one point when I was touching you, it said I might lose consciousness, which you said was adorable, and I just have to trust that you don't think I'm an idiot or some kind of an animal. I've never lost control due to overwhelming lust, but I must say that I'm changing my major to Joan. I'm changing my major to sex with Joan. I'm changing my major to sex with Joan, with a minor in kissing Joan. Foreign study to Joan's inner thighs. A seminar on Joan's ass in her Levi's. And Joan's crazy brown eyes. Joan, I feel like Hercules. God, that sounds ridiculous. Keep on sleeping through this and I'll work on calming down. So by the time you've woken up, I'll be cool, I'll be collected. I'll have found some dignity, but who needs dignity? Cause this is so much better. I'm radiating happiness. Will you stay here with me for the rest of the semester? We won't need any food. We'll live on sex alone. Sex with Joan. I am writing my thesis on Joan. It's a cutting edge field and my mind is blown. I would gladly stay up every night to hone my compulsory skills with Joan. I will study my way down her spine, familiarize myself with her well made out mind. While she researches mine, I don't know who I am. I've become someone new. Nothing I just did is anything I would do. Overnight everything changed, I was not prepared. I'm dizzy, I'm nauseous, I'm shaky. I'm scared. Am I falling into nothingness or flying into something so sublime? I don't know, but I'm changing my major to Joan. I thought all my life I'd be all alone, but that was before I was lying prone in this dorm room. Rolled on the pillow, so sweet, all sweaty and tangled up in my bedsheet, and my heart feels complete. Let's never leave this room. How about we stay here till finals? I'll go to school forever. I'll take out a dementedly huge high interest loan. Cause I'm changing my major to Joan.
on a land, the role of a lifetime. Well, you better get down on one knee, 'cause you could play the life of a party if you can pray with me.
Remember.
our secret. This winter sky, how can anyone sleep? There was never such a night before. I feel like putting my arms around my knees and squeezing tight as possible. High school girls with clear skin smiles who married young and then retired. The Valentines I never knew, the Friday night charades of youth were spent on one more beautiful. At 17 I learned the truth. And those of us with ravaged faces, lacking in the social graces, desperately remained at home, inventing lovers on the phone, who'd call and say, come dance with me, and murmur vague obscenities. It isn't all it seems. 17, a brown-eyed girl in hand-me-downs, whose name I never could pronounce, said, pity please the ones who serve, they only get what they deserve. And the rich relationed hometown queen marries into what she needs, guarantee of company and haven for the elderly. Remember those who win the game and lose the love they sought to gain. Indentures of quality, dubious integrity. The small town eyes will gaze at you in dull surprise. Exceeds accounts received at 17. To those of us who knew the pain of Valentines that never came, and those whose names were never called when choosing sides for basketball, it was long ago and far away. The world was younger than today, and dreams were all they gave for free to ugly duckling girls like me.
want love.
How many single ladies are out here looking for love tonight? Anyway, yeah? Yeah! Woo that sadness out! There's more where that came from. You see, ladies, I know what it is that you want. You want a guy that's sweet, a guy that's tough, a feminist who likes to pay for stuff, the kind of guy that gets along with your friends without being attracted to any of them. A good boy, a bad boy, a good bad boy, a half good, half bad, half boy. Loves your brother, sensitive but not weak, and is a great lover, calls your mother on the weekend. Now you might think that this guy only exists in your mind. Well, guess what? You're right. If you want love, lower your expectations a few, because Prince Charming would never settle for you. If you want love, just pick a guy and love him, and if he's got a thing for feet, say screw it, sweep me off him. Now, the good thing about guys is that at least they have realistic expectations about the woman they date. He said, sarcastically setting up a second verse in a comedy song. You want a girl that's nice, a girl that's not obsessed with her looks but is insanely hot, the kind of girl that you can show to your folks, loves the movies that you like and always laughs at your jokes. A real girl, a hot girl, a really hot girl, a brand new really hot real doll, wants to impress you, doesn't care if you notice, and only ever uses you to kiss her throat with. Now you might think that this girl only exists in your mind, but she's real. Last week, she died. If you want love, lower your expectations a lot. You might think your dick is a gift. I promise it's not. If you want love, just pick a girl and love her, and then be way too forward and let the girl you love decline the offer. I don't want a neat freak. I don't want a slob. Someone with a bedhead and a dead-end job. Because I won't settle for less. Perfect. We want perfect children, a perfect life, perfect husband or a perfect wife. But deep down we know we don't deserve it. But we all deserve love, even on the days when we aren't our best. Because we all suck, but love can make us suck less. We all deserve love. It's the very best part of being alive. And I would know, I just turned 25.
You say there's so much you don't know. You need to go and find yourself. You say you'd rather be alone, 'cause you think you won't find it tied to someone else. Who said it's true that the growing only happens on your own? They don't know me and you. I don't think you have to leave. If to change is what you need, you can change right next to me. When you're high, I'll take the lows. You can ebb and I can flow, and we'll take it slow and grow as we go. Grow as we go. You won't be the only one. I am unfinished, I've got so much left to learn. I don't know how this river runs, I'd like the company through every twist and turn. Ooh. the growing only happens on your own. They don't know me and you. You don't ever have to leave if the change is what you need. You can change right next to me. When you're high, I'll take the lows. You can ebb and I can flow. And we'll take it slow and grow as we go. Grow as we go. I don't know who will become. I can't promise it's not written in the stars, but I believe that when it's done, you're gonna see that it was better that we grew up together. Tell me you don't wanna leave, 'cause if change is what you need, you can change right next to me. I'll take the lows. You can ebb and I can flow. And we'll take it slow and grow as we go. Grow as we go. Grow as we go.
My sister Franny married a guy from her office, and Vicky's with a man whose house she sold. But I'm collecting tolls on the Jersey Turnpike, and I'm starting to imagine myself staying single, growing old. Lots of guys pass through, and you'd think they could chat for a minute or two, but no! It's always a rush with these men. But there's this one I'd kill to see again. Monday to Friday, he'd swing into my lane, my Tarzan commuter for his change-making chain. He'd give me a smile like he wished he could stay. The guy with the beanie in the blue Chevrolet. I came to expect him at 8:42-ish. I'm not really sure, but my boss thinks he's Jewish. He brought me a bagel one blizzardy day. That guy with the beanie in the blue Chevrolet. To tell you the truth, as he'd inch towards my booth, my chest would start pounding and my palms went damp. My legs went shaky and began to cramp. And there he'd be, and all I could manage to say was, "Never I stay." Then he drove away. Bye-bye, blue Chevrolet. Most of these drivers are as plain as can be. I don't think about them, and they don't think about me. But I've spent countless hours dreaming of my future fiancé with his needlepoint beanie and that rattly blue Chevrolet. Why does my tongue get tied in a knot when I'm faced with a thing I want a lot? Am I destined to sabotage my dream? Why did I blow every chance to confess? Was I waiting for him to just guess? Well, I waited too long, it seems. got himself an easy pass tag. Now he's whizzing by and I've hit a big snag. How can I reach you? I hear myself say to the back of his beanie, passing five lanes away. I could make an appeal to Officer Neal to take me for a ride in his trooper car, to find the blue Chevy with the 6-point star. We'd chase him with the siren till he pulled aside, and I'd run to his window all dewy-eyed. He'd leap from the car, we'd be face to face, and all of the pieces would fall into place. He'd beg me to start a family, him and me and Beanie Baby make three. Gee, you're probably thinking that I've hit a new low, chasing some guy whose name I don't even know. But if you'd seen his smile, I'm sure you'd feel the same way about my guy with the beanie in the blue Chevrolet. I know it's a crazy dream, but I'm gonna find him someday.
You're so ambitious for a juvenile, but then if you're so smart, tell me why are you still so afraid? Mm-hmm. Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You better cool it off before you burn it out. You've got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. But you know that when the truth is told, that you could get what you want, or you could just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. When will you realize the end awaits for you? For your time, though it's so romantic on the borderline tonight. Too bad, but it's the life you lead. You're so ahead of yourself, you forgot what you need. You can see when you're wrong, although you can't always see when you're right. You're right. Your passion, you've got your pride, but don't you know that only fools are satisfied? Dream on, but don't imagine they'll all come true. When will you realize Vienna waits for you? Slow down, you crazy. Take the phone off the hook and disappear for a while. It's alright, you can't afford to lose a day or two. When will you realize Vienna waits for you? Why don't
Dear sir, I write this note to you to tell you of my plight. For at the time of writing, I am not a pretty sight. Me body is all black and blue, me face a deathly grey. And I write this note to say why Gaby's not at work today. Well, working on the 14th floor, some bricks I had to clear, but tossing them down from such a height was not a good idea. My foreman wasn't very pleased, he is an awkward sod. He said I had to cart them down the ladders in me hod. Well, moving all these bricks by hand, it was so very slow. So I hoisted up a barrel and secured the ropes below. But in me haste to do the job, I was too blind to see that a barrel full of building bricks is heavier than me. So when I untied the rope, the barrel fell like lead. And clinging tightly to the rope, I started up instead. I shot up like a rocket, and to my dismay I found that halfway up I met the bloody barrel coming down. Oh, the barrel broke me shoulder as to the ground it sped. And when I reached the top, I banged the pulley with me head. But I clung on tightly, numb with shock from this almighty blow. Well, the barrel spilled out half its bricks some 14 floors below. Now when these bricks had fallen from the barrel to the floor, I then outweighed the barrel and so started down once more. And clinging tightly to the rope, my body racked with pain. Halfway down, I met the bloody barrel once again. Oh! The force of this collision, halfway down the office block, caused multiple abrasions and a nasty state of shock. But I clung untidily to the rope as I fell towards the ground and landed on the broken bricks. The barrel scattered round. As I lay there on the ground, I thought I'd passed the worst. But the barrel hit the pulley wheel, and then the bottom burst. A shower of bricks rained down on me. I didn't have a hope. And as I lay there bleeding, I let go the bloody rope. The barrel, now being heavier, it started down once more, and it landed right across me as I lay there on the floor. It broke three ribs and my left arm, and I can only say, I hope you'll understand why Gaby's not at work today.
A simple choice, nothing more. This or that, either or. Merry well, social world businessman, clever girl, or pin my future on the boy I love. What kind of life am I dreaming of? I say, gimme, gimme. Gimme, gimme.
me that thing called love. I want it. Give me that thing called love. I need it. Highs and lows, tears and laughter. Give me happy ever after. Give me that thing called love. Give me that thing called love. I crave it. Give me that thing called love. I'll brave it, thick and thin, rich or poor time. Give me years and all one more time. Give me that thing called love. Give me that thing called love. I'm free now. Give me that thing called love. I see now fly dove, sing sparrow. Give me Cupid's famous arrow. Give me that thing called love. I don't care if he's a nobody. In my heart, he'll be a somebody.
Don't forget me, Romeo and Juliet. Me fly dove, sing sparrow. Give me that boy's famous arrow. Give me that thing called love.
I'd get a second chance. I thought I was done, and I met you. No, I never dreamed I could learn how to love again. I placed my bet, and you came through. I somehow still lost. I somehow always do. But this time feels new. Thank you for finding me, and thank you for the care, and screw you for making me think that this life might be fair. You promised to love me, a promise you kept, and I won't be sorry for when you said to leap and I leapt. I won't regret what I did then, though it hurts more than I could imagine back when. All the same, even so, I would love you all over again. Am I always starting over every brand new morning? Am I always back at one after all I've done? 'Cause I burned all of my bridges and learned every last lesson too. So how can I start new? I love our children both fiercely and well. When they ask about you, oh Lordy, the stories I'll tell. And I won't regret the lives I didn't lead.
loved you. Let that be all that I need. Say that it's fate. Say it's foretold. I'm through with fighting it. I'm much too old. What the gods have to give, I'll take and I'll live and be.
Our life is-